What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the video. Justin here from the Killer Crossover, and today's video is going to be five reasons why I believe Kawhi Leonard should not go to the Lakers. Now, before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell to be notified of new videos that I drop. And also follow me on Instagram. I've got like 12K on there, trying to grow that. So yeah, follow me on that too. The Killer Crossover. I'm going to put it down in the description too. But anyway, starting off, number one, the most obvious thing, it hurts his legacy. If you go to a team that's already got LeBron James, one of the best players of all time, and then AD, who is arguably a top five, top 10 player, and you go there as a top five player, then I obviously hurt your legacy and you're going to be looked at as weak. Just like in 2019 now, 3 years ago, when Kevin Durant joined the 73-9 team, as I'm wearing a Golden State Warriors shirt, you're going to be looked at as weak. And so even though Kawhi Leonard had already planned on going to the Lakers, well, if he still does go, even though he already said that's where he wanted to go when he wanted to get out of San Antonio, nobody's going to acknowledge that. Like, you're still going to be looked at as weak, and that just hurts your legacy. So number two is, if he stays in Toronto, he can become the greatest Raptor ever. A lot of people are already saying that, but I don't think you get that title as greatest player of your franchise if you were there 1 year, and just because you were there that 1 year, you won a title. That doesn't make you the greatest. But if you stay there for a few years, even if you only win one more title, or even if you don't win any more titles, the fact that you were there for the first one, I think that would consider you the greatest Raptor ever. It was their first finals ever. And you know how crazy just the city of Toronto and the country of Canada went for him and their team, for them winning their first ever finals. So if he stays there, he's going to be the greatest Raptor ever. No debate. Number three is also dealing with, if he stays in Toronto. If he stays in Toronto, he gets to control the East, because the East is pretty top heavy. Free agency obviously isn't over. There's it goes on for a while. But pretty much all the major moves have been done already. Kevin Durant's out of here, so you're not really looking for Brooklyn to compete for a championship. So they're pretty much out. Only really two teams you have to worry about are the Sixers and the Bucks for right now, I would say. I don't think anybody else. Oh, and Indiana, if Oladipo comes back healthy, they're definitely a dark horse. It's only really two, maybe three other teams you have to worry about. And you being the defending champions, you've already got some clout. You've already got a good team around you, and they still have Gasol. Danny Green is still a free agent at the time of me making this video, so maybe he comes back, maybe he doesn't. But even if he doesn't come back, I still think they have a great chance to go right back to the finals again. So if he stays there, maybe recruit somebody else to come to Toronto. You can have a good solid team that can go to consecutive finals. Number four, if he decides to leave from Toronto and maybe go to the LA Clippers instead of the LA Lakers, he can start the Clippers legacy. The Clippers have always been a joke of a franchise, the Lakers' little brother. Nobody really takes them seriously. Obviously, they had Blake Griffin, DeAndre Jordan, and Chris Paul, but they never really did anything, even though those are three, star talents, filled the seats while the Lakers were on the decline. Kobe Bryant was going through injury. They pretty much just had scrubs on the team. Nobody really cared about the Lakers, and that was all Clippers. Kawhi Leonard, he could be that guy, right now they have a solid team. They have Lou Williams, Patrick Beverley. They have a good, solid squad. No superstars, but they were able to make the playoffs at least. So imagine adding that solid team and then adding Kawhi Leonard. If you go there and stay for a couple years, maybe until the end of your career, I don't know how long, you can be that guy. You can be the one that started the Clippers legacy. So that's just something he could think about. And number five, if you go to the Lakers, as much as we want to see a dynasty, there's no such thing as a current dynasty. I've only been watching basketball for maybe 10 years, not even. But when I first started watching basketball, it was when the big three in Miami came to be, Bosh, Wade, and LeBron. And, when they first were introduced, that little press conference, whatever, and LeBron was like, When he was asked how many championships they're going to win, he was like, not one, not two, not three, not four, not five. Like, they were going to win all these championships. But they went to four finals, only won two. And after their four finals appearance, LeBron left. Chris Bosh was plagued with injury, never really came back. And Dwayne Wade was just, he was just old. So, you know, that just fell apart after LeBron left. And obviously, as we're seeing with the Warriors, they went to four straight finals. Won three of those four finals, and now Klay Thompson's injured, Kevin Durant's injured, and with another team. So, you know, nothing lasts forever. LeBron is on, well, he's not on decline, but he's only got a few years left, you know. Maybe if he plays out his contract and maybe signs another contract, maybe at the most I'd say five more years in him. Maybe, because LeBron's not coming off somebody's bench. If LeBron can't start, if LeBron can't be dominant LeBron, he's going to retire. He's not going to be like Dirk and Wade coming off the bench to anybody. Anthony Davis has injury history. You don't know how well he's going to be. You don't know his longevity, his durability, you know. So that's something to think about, as well as Kawhi. Kawhi has injury history, obviously. He missed a lot of games this season during the regular season, but he pretty much played the whole playoffs. I don't think he missed a game in the playoffs. So, you know, you never know. It's one injury could, you know, change how long those guys stay together. Just change the chemistry of the Lakers. So you never know. But anyway, that's my top five reasons for Kawhi Leonard to not go to the Lakers. I'm also going to be making a video of the top five reasons why he should go to the Lakers. This is just a seeing it from both sides. So anyway, that's it, man. Thank you all for watching. Make sure to like this video, and I'll see you on the next one.